Good evening. I'd like to open the Deerfield Planning Board meeting for Monday, May 9th, 2016 at 7:10 at the town offices, 8 Conway Street in South Deerfield. And our agenda tonight is to review minutes of the April 4th meeting and then to have a public hearing. Then public comment. We might have some old business. And then our new business is an A&R at 75 Stillwater Road. Then we'll review the mail and set another date for the next meeting. Does anybody have anything to add to that agenda? Could I ask that we... we should do the minutes first. I was going to say switch, but some of the minutes have to do with this, what we're going to talk about tonight, so... but can I first add that congratulations, we had an election this past
congratulations to you.
Week that John Moronis has been reelected to the planning board.
Yippee.
And apparently, I was away last week, unfortunately, but apparently I was elected also.
You didn't vote.
So I didn't vote.
Did you get, did everybody get sworn in?
And I have not got sworn in.
Okay.
Have you?
Yes.
All right. So, do we have any leeway, or does that just mean I can't?
Abstain from
I just
votes.
Can't vote tonight. They don't give you any time.
No time.
Sorry.
Boy, time at all.
It's a tough
crowd.
Tough crowd. Yeah.
But I can still participate, I believe.
Well, we've got more than a quorum here. So
if not, you're the one
way.
Going to jail, not us.
No, and that's why I'm. That's why I want your approval. And apparently one of our members here has been elected to the select board, so congratulations.
Thank
Kip
you.
Kamosa. When does that start?
Last Friday, or last Monday, Tuesday.
Wow. Good for you. All right.
And we have another selectman.
Yeah, Trevor's here.
Trevor.
And then another new selectman. Yeah. Trevor, remind me your last name.
McDaniel.
Thank you. I knew it, but I didn't want to get it wrong. Trevor McDaniel. So congratulations. Wow, 2/3 of the select board is new.
Yeah.
Watch out, Deerfield.
And here, with us. Mm-hmm.
All right. But for the planning board, we do have a quorum. 6 of us. So let's review the planning board minutes from last month.
I'd like to make a motion that we accept the minutes with one edit that I see where on number 4 old business, including adding zoning change to EPD district. Yes, that was discussed, but it wasn't, you know, I think the board decided that property is more useful not having something that doesn't utilize the services that are there. When you read this, it almost reads that that's what we wanted, the EPD district. Maybe it doesn't need to be changed. What's everybody else's opinion, I guess?
I know, it looks like we didn't come to a conclusion, but
right.
In fact we did.
Well, it was voted, too.
And I think that's kind of important.
Didn't the town meeting vote it?
Yes.
Without the EPD.
That is correct.
Yeah.
So I'm not sure if it's a non-issue or moot.
Yeah. And then, you know, what we don't have is the minutes to the April 25th meeting, when there was actually a public hearing about that, which that's where it would have said that we weren't adding the EPD.
Right. So let's see. Paul was there, myself, Kip.
Who was there?
John Waite. So, and it was a very short meeting.
Yeah.
Right. But I think that would that came after
there was no
public comment. So
no, I agree. Yeah, right. There's probably no reason to
change this because we did discuss it back in April. All right. Is there a second to approve these minutes?
I'll second.
I'm present, but I was out. I left for the number five. It's not noted. I don't know if that's.
You're right. It should be.
Needs to be added.
That you recuse yourself.
I left. I absented myself.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I was there. And Trevor was absent.
Yeah, you were there.
I was present at that meeting.
So yeah, I think that's.
So we've got to add Max
so
to that.
So add Max to present. Was Roger here too? I think Roger was here.
No, Roger. At that last meeting,
too.
Yes, he was.
I think Roger was here too.
So you got to change that.
So we had Roger, Max to be in present, and then noting that at right before number five that Rachel
left.
And actually, well, maybe you make it again tonight, but you made a statement why you're leaving the meeting.
Mm-hmm. And I signed it.
That's right.
All right, with those changes, all in favor of approving the minutes from April 4th, aye.
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 Opposed, abstain.
Oh, it's one abstention. So it's got to be 5.
Oh.
So it's 5-0-1, right?
Sorry, shouldn't have voted. Do I just not vote or do I abstain?
Abstain.
Okay. I think you abstain, but I'm not sure.
I would say an abstention is.
All right, we're going to move on to the public hearing.
Yeah.
So I'll read the announcement that was written in the newspaper and posted out front. Town of Deerfield Planning Board, Notice of Public Hearing. Notice is hereby given that the Deerfield Planning Board will hold a public hearing on May 9th, 2016 at 7 p.m. at the Deerfield Town Hall, 8 Conway Street, on a request received from Alan Chase Foundation, DBA Eagle Brook School, for a site plan review regarding a proposal to install 2 ground-mounted solar arrays which will connect to the Eagle Brook campus. The combined power generation of the 2 arrays will be approximately 1,317 kilowatts. Arrays will be installed at the corner of Keats and Jingle Hill Road, and the assessor's map location is here, and off of Rice Ferry Road. The location is zoned RA, residential agricultural. Copies of the site plans and site plan application are available for inspection at the Deerfield Town Hall during regular business hours. So we've got some representatives from this project.
Yes.
Did you give them the sign-in sheet?
It's right there. Did we put it to right. Passer?
Yeah.
All right.
I don't want to mess this.
So that's got you guys on it. And just before you start, I think one of our members
wants to recuse herself.
Hey, let me leave the building.
Due to a potential conflict of interest.
Well, you can hang around for the rest of the meeting.
Not that it,
yeah.
So Rachel is excusing herself for this portion, so that gets in the minutes, right?
Yep.
All right. Hey, you want to introduce yourself and tell us a little about the project?
Sure. Jeff Squire, Berkshire Design Group. Here on behalf of Eagle School. What they're proposing are 3 small ground-mounted solar arrays going to the campus. Central campus is here, products down here. First, it's located off Keats Road, largely in this cleared open meadow area that's there now. There's a little bit of tree removal involved, no greens in the center, but most of this. The advantage of this field is just because it's already open.
Guys, does this get on the camera?
Sure.
Can you see the map? Oh, good.
The other arrays are located adjacent to the residence off of Rice's Ferry Road. There's one on the north side, there's one on the south side between the residence and the track. As you mentioned in the advertisement, all three arrays together will generate about 1,300 kilowatts. And that's going to be combined with some additional roof-mounted solar arrays that are being part of the current building expansion project. But this is the Keats Road site. Again, it's contained all within largely the meadow area. There's no resource area disturbances. There's very little other work that needs to happen on this site. The Rice's Ferry site, again, here's the track residence. Rice's Ferry Road is on this side. The arrays for this site are, again, you know, on either side, north and south of the existing residence. Mostly in, you know, existing lawn area. There's some tree clearing that does need to happen there. This is a sparsely wooded hillside. So again, you know, there'll be some clearing required down there, but it's not, you know, it's not a clear cut, you know, forest situation. There was a stormwater permit application that was submitted. I know that went out for peer review, and we haven't received any comments back. And I'm aware or under the impression that all the land protection issues, the Chapter 61 issues and all that paperwork has been resolved with regards to the Keats Road site.
Have you received notification from the town about that? Because that was one thing that was...
I believe, yeah, I don't know, Wes Smith can from Eaglebrook can speak to it maybe?
Yeah, we haven't... We were actually waiting up for this meeting to hear back from that, but we haven't received official anything official, any paperwork that's official saying that is out. But from our conversations, it was a non-issue. But I didn't know if that was something that would be received from this group or not.
Well, we have two selectmen in the room.
Before our time.
I thought it wasn't... Well, then, if it was
my understanding is that the selectman refused the right, you know, first refusal, and to you know, bypass the waiting period.
Right, that's what I was hoping they were going to give you something. Think, that said we're going to bypass the waiting period.
I think they. My understanding is that both of those were done.
Yep.
And they voted on it. I don't know. I haven't seen any correspondence or letters to that effect.
All right, and we'll follow up with that. Is that something you can check with Doug? Might know more about it. No, we're asking actually about the 61A or?
Yes, 61A.
The town has right of first refusal to release a 61A. Just ask Doug that, he'll know, mm-hmm. I think.
So my understanding was at a meeting a couple of weeks ago that was voted on and they were in favor of it,
but I didn't know if they voted on it yet.
Haven't received any official correspondence, but have.
I know.
I did see that on television that they did vote on, but I don't.
Okay. All right. So we'll just follow up with that.
Okay.
But that's fine.
If there's something that we need, yeah. And then in regards to the stormwater, the peer review, yeah, our understanding it did go out to Franklin Regional Council of Governments for peer review.
Right.
And we haven't gotten any comments or correspondence back from them.
They would not have.
Well, the other thing in our minutes, of course, it says that that if the deposition of the Chapter 61 restriction was removed, then you guys could move forward and they would let you know. So I guess we got to assume that it was positive.
Well, you don't assume anything. We want to see it in writing, but you're right. For now, we don't have to deal with that issue.
Right.
Eventually, you need to get the actual sign thing. But that's fine. And the, so we're in the process of getting the peer review. And again, the former select board, now we can blame them on everything, didn't approve the contract with the FERCOG. And so you guys, I guess, did it tonight. So we'll get that going. But then we also want Newman.
Okay.
Going to do the peer review on that.
Is this accurate? Because we've spoke to representatives with FERCOG, and they've actually gone through the process.
Right. I know. We were hoping she was going to be here tonight, but because of the contract, it couldn't be. But that's who's going to do the site plan review. But they're not
equipped to do the,
to do the stormwater. So we just need a little bit more.
The last correspondence I had from them, there was a contract with Newman initially.
Yeah.
That never got executed because
that was going to be from the Conservation Commission in case they usually use him.
Right. And
since they don't need to be involved.
Correct.
You said, well, we'll just use him for our piece of the stormwater.
Right, right, right. And so I inquired of him as if he had heard anything from the planning board or the select board, yeah, you know, with regards to peer review, never heard anything. Right. And then the next piece of information we got was, you know, that had gone out to peer review to FERCOG and had asked for, you know, stormwater permits and all the calculations. So I had assumed that that was the peer review that was being done for, you know, for the project.
No, there's two different ones.
Yes, she had a contract as well.
There's a technical, you know, assistant peer review from the FERCOG for the site plan review, and then the technical assistance is for the engineering for the wetlands or for the stormwater bylaw, and that goes through Newman's.
Yeah, I think that's who we got.
We use those.
Okay.
All right, so we'll speed that up, though, because we don't want that to slow things down. And the reason why we're going to do the full site plan review, but a lot of stuff is just pretty easy. I mean, traffic and those kind of things that we normally look at isn't a big issue. So stormwater ends up being for both the site plan review and the stormwater review. That's the main thing we're going to be looking at.
Sure, sure. Yeah, I guess, okay.
Yeah, I mean, we were under the impression that was already behind us. I mean, we took everything out of the resource areas of ConCom, which is when the original when we were originally going to go to Newman, and then we were told that we didn't have to worry about that, and we would just have to be worried about that FERCOG was basically just reviewing the application, right? That we weren't going through a technical, another third-party peer review.
Well, my question would be, who told you that? Yeah. And when you said you were told that
Conservation Commission originally.
Oh. Yeah.
All we needed to do was go through the FERCOG review for the application process.
All right, so the planning board in this case, we're the stormwater authority. Yeah. Stormwater permit authority? Yeah.
Yes.
And it's partly because in the site plan review, it's also about stormwater. So we kind of try to make it easy for you. So, but we all decided on this board and the FERCOG that we're not the professional engineers to look at all those numbers. So that's when we usually pull in someone else.
Okay.
For a review of that, and we haven't done that yet.
Okay, and that's what I was.
But we need
I guess I'm a little confused because I have the stormwater permit application, the engineering consulting fee acknowledgement form filled out for Eagle Brook, and pretty much every page is stamped with Newman Environmental Engineering on it.
Yep.
So.
We had signed a contract with him initially.
Yeah.
That, again, never. Because it was a Conservation Commission related issue originally.
I see.
We asked if we could use the same contract, inquired of, you know, of Greg, and I think, you know, through discussions with the town administrator and, you know, I think the last presentation, the expectation was that we were going to follow through with him, and he needed to get an official word from the board or from the town that, you know, we need to execute this contract. It couldn't come from us because that was for the Conservation Commission.
So it looks like we needed to contact them.
Right. All right. So that's.
And so I thought, right. And so then when we got, you know, a contract from FERCOG, our assumption was that rather than going with Newman Environmental, you know, Newman Engineering, that it was going with FERCOG.
Yeah.
And there was very, you know, there wasn't anything to the effect that this is limited to only the site plan application. Because she was asking for all the, you know, all the information that we had provided, all the stormwater calculations, the permit, all of that.
The people from Newman's, is it Greg Newman?
Yes.
Right. They're the ones that have to, you know, develop all the calculations and stuff. Mm-hmm. And all of Pat Smith's role is just to, you know, take his information and compare it to the bylaws to make sure that it jives.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
So anyway, I don't think that'll be a problem, but it's not, it just hasn't been done.
Sure.
Yeah.
Well, yeah, and I think the bigger issue is just the delay, you know, that it creates, because I think, yeah.
Well,
we'll see if it delays anything. Hopefully not. So that's the first thing we got to get as a contract and have him look over. These numbers are from you.
Yes.
Right? So he just has to review these.
Right.
All right. All right. And did you get feedback from anybody at the FERCOG about other issues or?
We haven't.
Yeah. Okay. But
she had more correspondence.
She did right. get it and is looking at it. So this will be the one that.
So what's the timeline? If we contact Newman's and have him get the information to Pat, and then Pat can report back to us.
I mean, yeah.
What are we really?
I think we're talking a couple of weeks. Which is normal. I mean, this is the first, this was the first public hearing, and usually there's stuff that comes up after it. And, we normally meet every month. If we have to, we can meet in between then.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Well, this is the second. Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, I understand it was delayed for other reasons, but I don't think we delayed it prior to this. So.
Well, if we get the information from Newman's to Pat, probably at our next meeting, we would have all the information so we could approve the project.
Absolutely.
Right. And we're already into the second week of May, so it's really not that far away.
Well, provided that, and I guess the only caveat would be depending on what Greg's schedule is and how quickly he can get to review the project, because he hasn't technically reviewed it at all yet. He hasn't looked at it. So there's going to be some back and forth, I'm sure.
But we're having a public hearing now.
Right.
And is anybody here to talk about it besides the engineers?
No, that's what we're waiting. We'll finish their presentation, and then we'll start getting questions.
Okay.
All right. Do you happen to know where the lights are, Tur?
No, but I bet you I can find them.
Would you mind? This is a good thing to learn.
Sure. Right, you should know where they are.
I have no idea. I think they're in
They're in that left-hand door there.
And I don't know what they are. They labeled some of them, and then you just
get a try. There's four of them all together
sorry,
on the left
I think the sun just went down over the,
yeah, it did.
Over the horizon there.
Well, we shouldn't meet past daylight anyways.
Oh, is that how it should be?
Part of the town.
Yeah.
Thank you. I want to acknowledge that the Dew Selectman knows where the lights are now in the town hall, and I think that...
We'll put it down that Trevor Daniels took care of the lighting. McDaniels.
All right.
I guess at this point, I don't have any questions on it.
Yeah, well, let's see if there's anybody else in the... You gave us that's a good summary.
Yeah, I don't... There's not
all right, so one thing we did... So you got to run a conduit from... Keith Road.
A conduit run down an existing, existing, wood trail, off-road trail that'll connect to the campus.
So how much does that have to be, dredged? I mean, what are you going to use?
It's going to be a simple, trenching, walk-by trenching machine, I'm sure. They're going to do, whatever they can do a day and backfill it. And
just goes under a foot or two or something? Or,
yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. There isn't much involved with that.
Any questions? Anybody else? All right, planning board.
I'm good. My only thing is, who's going to contact Newman's? Somebody can do it tomorrow. Doug's not going to be here all week, so.
Oh, he's out all week.
Yeah.
So do we? And we're going to continue this meeting till next meeting, or do we? Because we don't want to close it yet, do we? Or do we? I think we want to keep it open until we see that to finalize it, don't we?
Yeah, that's normally what we do. I mean, we can close it and still not make a decision, but that means no new information can come in or something. So it's always usually good to keep it open.
Yep. John, do you want to contact them tomorrow? Or would you like me to do it?
I would love someone else to. So
come do it.
Want to do it?
I'll contact
them. And I think I'm trying to think if Pat is back yet either, because I thought she had some quick dialogue with Greg too.
All right. Well, I'll
but anyway,
just...
he knows something about the project, so he can get him.
I will call him tomorrow, first thing in the morning.
And at this point, I don't think, part of it is we gave you an estimate on the peer review, and I think that's in that same number, probably.
Yes, I don't know.
Yeah. Last time we had a separate number in contract with Newman before it got pulled, and then... We pulled that. We were just about to have him go do the peer review. Then that got pulled out when Conservation said, you don't need to do this. It's out of jurisdictional area. And when we went with the planning board, we asked to use that same contract, but we could not, so we did a separate contract with a separate number, whether not to exceed. So I'm just seeing how this is going to motion. It's taken time in between each meeting every time to get contracts in place with the town, with the individual, with the third party reviewer. So whatever we could do to expedite this, because that, you know, we asked
what you can do is just be supplying the best information you have. Yeah.
Which
so if you've done that, again, this is our first official meeting on it. So normally we do a public hearing, then there's work done in between. Sometimes it takes 1 month.
Yep.
Sometimes it takes more. This should be a quick one. So
sure.
I don't see a problem with it. All right. Yeah. So that'd be great if you could contact him.
Okay.
Any other questions?
With, go ahead.
It's unclear. So Mr. Moser will be contacting Mr. Newman to get him to give the information about the stormwater to pass him for
Perfect. Perfect.
Because commercial net metering is on hold, how will that affect your project, or will it at all? Do you plan on using all of your capacity, so it's not really going to matter?
Yeah,
I imagine
this is going to be 83% of our load, so we're going to be directly behind our metering, so we're not doing.
So it really doesn't matter.
No, for us, it's a timeline because we have to get this online by the end of the year. So as this is getting pushed back, our construction schedule is getting further and further pushed back.
Right.
That's where my anxiety is.
I understand.
I don't want to miss that boat with the program that the state's running.
Now, shame on me for not bringing my book today, but this is considered a mid-size.
Yes.
Which I don't think mid-size is a mid-size.
Or what is it, a large scale or extra large? Large.
It's not extra. Yeah, we didn't change it.
Well, I called it mid-scale, but it's large.
Yeah,
but is that allowed in RA?
It is with, yes. Planning board review.
Site plan review.
It is, okay.
Right.
And I might add, just early on, that Eagle Brook is a considered a nonprofit, potentially exempt from site plan review. But I know the building inspector said that a project like this is visible to people in town, and it's a good idea to do it. So we appreciate you doing this, and that's again why we don't want to delay it for you.
Yep.
All right. Up on Keith Road, is there any kind of fencing that's going around there, and what's the?
Yeah, there'll likely be some chain link fence around this one. We'll probably do something a little bit more ornamental around the residence off of Rice's Ferry, just because it is adjacent to a residence. But it'll be a 6 foot high chain link fence.
And there is some tree cutting.
There's a little bit along this edge here.
That's kind of the south
toe of the slope. Yeah, yeah. Yeah. Mm-hmm. But the rest of it is all. And then there's an isolated stand of six spruces or something in the center of the field that will come down. But there's a hedge buffer there of large evergreens that will stay.
Oh, okay.
So a lot of that will be behind a lot of that, right?
Right.
And they're going to use the existing gravel access road, for access to the site. So there won't be many changes visible from the road.
All right. That's what I was wondering, because a wooden fence there, but that's not really a
right.
A protective fence at all, but okay. Yeah. So you leave those trees up. That's good.
We tried. We spent a lot of time trying to choose areas with minimal impact.
Yeah.
All right. Wes, I think I see your signature on these applications. Is that correct?
Yep.
Your firm. Do you know what you've paid in fees for both of these site plan application and the stormwater application?
I don't know the exact number, including the peer reviews as well.
No, not peer review. Just what you paid for the application fees for one for the site plan review and the other one for the stormwater review. You don't remember? Okay.
No.
Because it wasn't a dollar amount on here, or at least I didn't see it.
I know.
I've got record of that.
It was $3,250.
Yeah.
$3,250.
That's it. Maybe.
Yes.
Yep.
Okay.
But I guess what I was getting at is there was only that one fee that we did not charge them for both.
I don't believe there was a separate Well, there's $100, they paid $100 for the stormwater application, stormwater permit application.
But there was none of that land disturbance fee because it's all considered the same.
Yeah.
Okay.
Well, it hit that maximum level.
Right, right.
Right.
3,000.
It was that maximum level, and then there was a planning board fee on top of that, correct?
A 250, yeah. And then you're aware of the solar that's just down further on Keats Road.
Correct.
In the quarry.
Across the, right.
Yeah, so I just let you know that that's happening too.
Right, right. Yeah, we're aware.
I did get one, so we send requests for comments out to different boards. And actually that's another thing we, after the public hearing, we try to go and really push them to give us some comments, whether it's police, fire. In this case, we got it from the Conservation Commission. And they said after speaking with the CONCOM members, we have no comment on this project. We have no comment as this project is no longer jurisdictional for us. So that was, so I guess since it wasn't under their jurisdiction, they don't want to make any other comments. And then who else do we try to get them from?
Police, fire, DPW.
Board of Health, building commissioner. Building commissioner's already talked to you. Select board, have anything to say? Highway superintendent. But I don't think. I mean, the fire access is the same as it always has been. That you'll leave that road. I know that was an issue once. You had a fence up there, and the fire department couldn't get in. But I think, do they now have access to that fence?
They have a key to that gate.
On both ends, or?
It's only on one end. It's just on the Keats Road end.
Is the gate?
Because it's a public, road from Rice's Ferry side.
Oh, okay. But there's a gate on the other end of that. It's not Rice's Ferry. It's just, I don't think it has a name, that other trail.
Mud Mile?
Well, no, I'm actually talking about if you're going straight in instead of turning over to Eagle Brook. I don't know what the name of that road is.
Dingle Hill Road? It's a discontinued road?
Yeah.
Hill Road? Yeah, so that's the access road that we're going to use for the site, but it's it's a discontinued road.
Yeah. All right.
So it's actually all Eagle Brook property now.
And then where are the inverters?
There'll be a small one here. Yeah, and then there's one also on the Rice's Ferry site.
Most of that type of infrastructure is going to be on the Keats Road site. Right? There will be a smaller micro inverter on the other side.
And I know on the other solar project we had, noise was an issue. So what kind of noise does that make?
I don't anticipate there'd be much noise. I don't know. Yeah, I don't know.
Right. In terms of a nominal, I mean, it's. I don't have the exact hertz rating on what you're...
All right. So that's like one thing that I know, that's the thing Pat'll ask about is just get some information about the type of inverter or something. Because, I mean, there's not many residents up there, but there is one, there's a couple not too far down the hill. And I think it's easy if there is any kind of noise going in that direction, you put some kind of barrier there just to make sure the sound doesn't go down that direction. Otherwise it's our wildlife up there. I guess they adjust. Anything else?
Good.
All right, so I know, so over the next week or two, Pat Smith will send you her questions, but again, I know she had looked it over before, a week or two ago, and seemed like it was going to be pretty straightforward. So that we'll plan either the first Monday of June. I mean, that'd kind of be the easiest for us. Just give us that as a kind of a deadline, make sure that we get all this work done, and then we have our normal meeting, and then we'll close this public hearing and make the do the decision. And site plan reviews are, as you know, probably that, it's kind of hard for us to say no.
Sure.
More than anything. It's about conditions.
Right.
And again, seeing that there's not a lot going on, it's probably going to be pretty easy. So.
And is our next meeting will be June 6th?
Well, that's what we got to decide, but okay. So maybe we do that, and then we can actually put in the minutes that this will be continued until then.
Yeah.
So does that work for everybody, the first Monday in June? Is that a holiday or anything?
Works
June,
for me.
June 6th?
Yep.
So the next meeting will be June 6th at 7 o'clock, and we can put at the top of the agenda the continuation of this public hearing, which we don't have to advertise again.
Right.
And again, we like to keep it open just in case new information comes, then we can consider it, but it should be pretty straightforward.
You need me to look into exactly what we've paid?
No, you can. I just wanted to make sure that you didn't get charged twice.
Well, any funds that aren't expended go back to them anyway, so it doesn't matter.
Well, no, not the fee. The $3,250 comes to the town. That's the fee.
Okay.
The other is for peer review. That would come back.
Yeah, anything that's contracted with somebody.
Peer review would, right.
Yeah,
right.
Would go back to you.
It's only $1,000. You guys get $2,000 back.
Yeah.
Just quickly, so you're calling it two ground-mounted solar arrays, but it's three, is it?
Two sites.
It's on two sites. The second array is just on either side of a.
Yeah. All right. Here it keeps saying two arrays instead of two sites, but I mean, not that it just got confused me last time I read that. All right. So should we have a vote to continue this public hearing?
I don't know if we have to vote it. Do we? We just continue it.
All right.
If we don't close it, we just and it's continue.
Yeah, I don't think it requires a vote.
All right. So we'll continue this public hearing at
June 6th.
I don't think
yeah.
There's any other information that we need until
tonight. Yeah.
So we're good to go. We can move on.
Thanks very much.
Thank you.
See you
thanks.
In 3 weeks.
Great.
Thanks. Wes, if this Mr. Newman needs to contact anyone, it'd be you.
Yep, that's fine.
Okay.
Been in contact with Jeff, but he can certainly contact me as well.
Do you have a card by any chance?
I don't.
I'll find you.
Okay.
Do you have one, Jeff? A card?
I do.
Should I leave my cell phone on the?
As long as he can reach out to one of you, right?
Yeah.
Thank you.
He has both of our contact info.
Oh, did you need that, or could I?
You can have it. I just want to put it down here, that's all.
Is there anything else? No.
I'll call him first thing in the morning, and
appreciate
I'll
it.
Keep pounding him until I get a hold of him and tell him he needs you. You know, if, for some reason, he tells me, you know, like, he's busy or whatever, is there someone else that you...
I don't know. Maybe Doug or hopefully someone at the town or else the CONCOM maybe has someone else we can check in with them.
Does it really make a difference who? I mean, there's other...
No, that's why I'm...
I could reach out to Marcus. I don't know if they... I think they would do it in New England Environmental.
I mean, if Newman, because he's already had a cursory review of this...
Here again, I don't want to, you know, if I know that there's something that might hold it up, I want to be able to move and go do something else. All right.
I forgot, I should have mentioned, you also have the special permit application. And I think that's because it's the RA district.
It's a size, yeah. I think it's a size thing, isn't it, too?
Right? Oh, okay.
I think it's a size, yeah.
All right.
We were talking about maybe changing that, but that's down the road away.
We're combining all these public hearings and all the information, so it'll all be done at the same time.
Thank you.
Yep, thank you.
I just want to make that clear. All right. And then they did, I should have said this, but they did, the public notice did go out to all the abutters. And we've got that list. Seems like all the abutters are also Eagle Brook School.
Funny how that works.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Deerfield Fire District got it, and then, well, that is interesting that, I'm just looking, I'm wondering what, okay, I should double check that. The one resident at the top of Keats Road, which is the closest to this, is not on the list. But it could be because WT land comes in between them. Because you know how that whole, all that area is either Eagle Brook
right.
or, you know, Warner Brothers, and then a few other people down below it. All right, public comment. Does anybody in the audience have anything to talk about with the planning board tonight? Often the fast-moving part of the business. Old business?
Do you want to take up the fact about changing the size and the requirements of those solar arrays?
Well, I've done a little bit of work just on the residential end of it to start. And currently, right now in Massachusetts, residential is considered 25,000 watts. With a SunPower 325-watt panel, a 25,000-watt system is 13 feet, four panels high or wide by 120 feet wide, which is 1,560 square feet. We had talked about maybe going to square footage versus
how many panels would that total?
That's around 80 panels.
80 panels.
Yeah, I should know that exact number, but it's around 80 panels.
Okay.
John, are you saying on residential there's a limit to the size of the panels?
No. I'm just
okay.
But the panels become more efficient.
Efficient.
Right.
Smaller.
And they're getting smaller.
Same footprint, you get more power. So therefore, he's saying use the footprint rather than the kilowatt output.
And for clarity, we only regulate ground mounted. If somebody puts it on the roof, then it doesn't.
I'm quite sure you are correct with that. Yes, I think on a roof.
I mean, in our regulations, we only deal with ground mounted.
Right, okay. Right. So
the question was, do we want to talk about this tonight? So we started talking about it, but I guess what's the objective here?
The objective is with a ground mount system, a home that uses 13,000, 15,000 watts of worth of electricity cannot supply their own needs with a ground mount system the way that we have it written now. 10,000 watts is a number that we threw out there when we did the original bylaw.
10,000 watts?
10,000 watts, which is 10 kilowatts.
Okay.
Well, can I make a suggestion that we each on our own, before our next meeting, look at this,
the options,
and then
in
our next meeting, maybe we can discuss getting rid of all the kilowatt size and just go to a square footage thing, even for all the different, the large ones as well.
Can I add to that suggestion,
sure,
then? Because everybody can do their own research. But again, this is one of these things that everybody in the country, in the world, is thinking about solar, and all the towns are coming up with this, and I don't see why we all, every town in Massachusetts or Franklin County has to go
right
through this. So let's look at what
somebody else has done.
There must be some best practices out there.
Yep. Sounds good.
I think we did that back when we did this three or four years ago, and now maybe there's new ones. So.
Yeah. Well, and there's innovations. I mean, the efficiencies are so
changed.
Well,
that's why we're saying that.
Yeah.
Well, where I was going with my thought was, instead of having, we do site plan review anyways. Why have a site plan review and a special permit review? And, why not we narrow our permitting thing down to a much easier and less,
cumbersome,
troublesome and expensive
now,
form
now,
of
residential has as of right certain solar requirements too, doesn't it?
Residential roof mounted, yeah.
Roof mounted.
Yeah. Yeah.
And then ground mounted if it's tiny, if it's small.
Right.
Well, I guess the bottom line is, after however many years that we've implemented solar
zoning, as most other towns have done, I think we can agree that solar is here to stay, that it's not just a fad.
And it does make more sense to be a footprint rather than power because of the technology changing as rapidly as it does.
I did read in the paper that Town of Leverett just redid their solar zoning, and it was a footprint versus, yeah, so, you know, maybe, are you going to ask Pat Smith maybe to pull some?
That's what I thought, would just get her to do some. I think all the towns are doing it. I know Montague and Shelburne and Greenfield, they're all doing it, so.
Yeah. Okay.
All right, so let's keep that on our agenda, and I'll talk to Pat about what the FERCOG knows about what's going on. And I think there's CEC or Center for Environmental something.
I'm not sure.
A program in Massachusetts that does this kind of stuff too. So, all right, good. So, but I think so. Our consensus is that we do want to look into making changes to it to make it more both size and what we require.
When you talk to Pat, I mean, are you just going to ask her not to do research, or, you know, I mean,
I think we wanted to get sort of best.
Well, I mean, right? Yeah, I just didn't want to end up with a $2,000 bill in all these pages of, you know.
Right, but I guess this is my own opinion. That I like it when professionals do it. If you do it and Max does it and I do it and John does it and Paul does it, I still feel like that's not as. How do we then bring that together? You know.
Well, we talk about it. I mean,
But we're not all professionals at this, and that's why, to some extent, I'd like to leave some of this finer detailed stuff to the professionals.
Pat's an expert solar person.
But
she's a researcher, you know, and that's what I think all of us are kind of capable of doing a little bit. And I don't know. I mean, I have no problem asking her. I just...
You're right. There's an amount of money thing that we don't want to be spending.
You know, and if she says, oh, yeah, I can do it in a couple of hours, and we get a bill for $150, that's fine.
Right.
But I don't want her to bring a package like this along with the bill.
So let me ask... I'll ask her for a proposal.
Okay.
On what they're seeing in the other towns, and maybe give us a proposal on how we could go about it.
Great.
That's what I would ask for. Okay. Yeah. That's good. Because this isn't something we need to change immediately.
No.
I think one of my biggest points is, as far as residential, a person should be able to
supply
their own needs.
Yeah.
You know, so with the state of Massachusetts, with their residential considered at 25,000 watts, I think if we can go in that direction, but, you know, getting what the zoning is for solar and other towns currently that have been updated in recent the last couple of years would be very helpful for us. And I think streamlining the large scale and even the extra large scale would be helpful also. Extra large scale and large scale will be kind of slowing down with the
credits start to wear out.
Being the maxing out of net metering for commercial arrays is going to slow down any large scales until if and when they allow net metering on commercial again.
All right, so we'll keep that on next time. New business, we have an A&R from 75 Stillwater. Can I keep that away?
It's a neighbor.
I don't see any plans here.
Mark, what did you say you were from?
This is him.
Oh.
Yeah, that's what I thought.
Okay, do you have any plans? Any
There's usually plans for it.
Things.
Hold on. Because
we got to have those.
We got a disc in here, so.
Well, yeah, but she's going to go get it.
We just have it.
Normally we have that here.
It's a tip off. It's a look.
Would you mind coming up? Because they've got the microphones too for our audience there. And So I have an application from Sarah. The name of the applicant is Sarah
Carroll.
Yes, that's my wife.
All right. And it's...
Could you spell your last name for me?
C-H-R-A-B-A-S-C-Z.
C-Z?
Yeah.
Okay.
And it says it's from for the parcel at 75 Stillwater Road, and it's to cut out 5-acre lot from original 20-acre lot, create 5-acre lot with building and a 15-acre vacant lot. And I got the application, and it's been... fee of $150 has been paid.
Oh, take the two for now.
Okay, we'll take two.
Oh, there's the town clerk's signature and stamp. All right. On May 2nd. All right, can you want to just describe what it is that's on the plan?
Yeah. The 5-acre lot basically just includes it's a large Morton building right there, 72 feet by 300 feet. There's also a small shed up on the side, but it's a very rough shed. And
is that what's called barn here?
Yeah. Yeah. Oh. It's an old pole barn.
So right now it's just that one big parcel?
Yes.
And you just want to cut out this 5 acres?
Yep. The 5 acres was designated by Richard for farming. You needed 5 acres. You wanted
right
Deerfield. So
I'm noticing the name of the abutter.
Yeah.
Yes.
He's been a great neighbor.
Similar name to.
I won't vote, but I'm just saying he's been a great neighbor.
All right, but that's what I just wanted to be clear that so you should
he's
not.
Like a nice guy.
Well, whether he's been a great neighbor or not is irrelevant because everything to me looks like it meets.
I don't see any.
The setback is 25 feet, correct?
It's not a subdivision.
The setback on the side, you mean?
Yeah.
It's not 25 feet. It's 10, I think.
Is it?
Yeah. Is it in? Well, not yet. Yeah, in RA, is it 10? I don't know. We'd have to look at
I was questioning, I didn't know if it was 25 or 30, but.
It's a lot less than 27.
I think it's less than 27 for sure.
No, in Williamsburg, I know it's 10. It's where I live now.
I thought it was 10 here, but then again, this is RA, so it could be different there.
Well, this isn't the book. This is the other thing.
Oh, yeah, mine. Look at
we
this.
Have our dimensional.
You have your book? Oh, thank you.
Yeah.
I usually bring mine, too.
Yeah, I have
one in the box too.
300.
No, there isn't. It's a
dimensional 179.
Is that 12?
Is that 179? Yeah, chapter 1.
This one's already existing, so it's nothing.
It is 10
on
feet
on the barn side, wow. But this one's
it is 10 feet.
2300
side.
Yeah.
What does it say?
Side.
Why
10.
Did I think it was more
for RA?
Yeah.
What does it say?
10 feet.
That's what I thought. I wasn't sure, but I thought it did.
Well, let me see what 8 is.
It's like 25. It's 25 on the frontage, isn't it, Kip?
What's that?
If it's 25 on the front of the lot, 10 on all sides.
Front setback is 30 feet.
30, okay.
30, 10, 10.
With the setback, side yards, let me just see.
No odd angles. I'd like to make an endorsement, a motion to endorse the plan.
Mm-hmm. Second.
So you've got the front end, you've got the square footage.
Yeah.
Both properties, no front
access.
Angle.
Yeah.
Access is there. And then this is... we're not calling anything a building lot, though, because that's...
No.
That's somebody else's job.
But where does it say? Usually it's supposed to say that on here. Planning board endorsement under the subdivision control law should not be construed as either an endorsement or an approval of zoning requirements.
Right there.
Yes. Paul Ellis.
Paul Ellis, yep.
Okay.
There's a motion and a second to endorse this. All those in favor?
Aye.
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 Against? Abstain?
Okay.
Didn't you get my text?
I didn't have time to get down here today. Anyway.
So it's 402.
1, 2, 3, 4, 0, 2. So it's approved. So you four that approved it have to sign it.
Got it.
Each copy.
All right.
We can sign it with any old pen, right?
Yeah, I think so.
That's funny.
Let's see if it...
Here, make sure you get the Mylar.
You just can't put medical marijuana in it.
It's upside down.
Oh, this is there's a daycare
here,
or something.
Take four.
Well, that's why we have medical marijuana in it.
Sign those quick, and then you can sign this one.
Here, will you show these copies?
Sorry. Yeah. Oops. It was any old thing here.
Mm-hmm. So it's a $100 fee plus 50 per new lot, and there was one new lot because it correct. Went from one lot to two lots.
Yeah.
So that's why it's 150. So just want to make sure we get our math right.
Thank you.
I think you have to take one of these.
Mylar.
The Mylar.
You can have one of the others too if you
yeah.
want.
You getting them now?
Yeah. Let's see.
Oh. I don't know which one she's going to take. He's going to take.
It's important.
Yeah. Rachel, you can sign the top of this one. This is a Mylar. And who else is signing, John?
Yeah, I'll wait. I'll let everybody get out of there.
Okay.
And
all right, yeah.
I'll sign. Because otherwise the signatures are all over the map.
Well, they're always in different orders. I don't think it matters. It would be nice if it was together. All right, let's look.
I guess that way you know they're originals, right?
Oh, I like this. He's put, remember we asked him, all the mail was just piling up, so now he's got mail archive.
Hopefully okay, John.
Oh, you're done.
Sign that one.
John, do you know the password for the town's Wi-Fi here?
Do you know?
I don't. Kat, do you know the password?
For no, you? She just said she doesn't.
Oh.
Oh well.
Is there?
Yes, or something.
Yeah.
Something.
There is Wi-Fi. I mean, there is Wi-Fi,
yeah.
there, but it's locked.
I think, so. Yeah. You need a password.
I know. So, Paul, when you have the computer here, you usually don't go on.
No, that's the thing. I wish we could, but.
Well, we can if we got.
Well, yeah, I know, but
well, maybe everybody should get their own private server.
That's right.
Yeah.
That's right.
I know that there's a way to use your phone,
like
but I don't know how to do it.
Like Hillary Clinton.
Oh. She said, I wasn't even thinking about that.
Yeah, I know. Yeah, I figured that was the...
That was the reference.
It's
that
a
was
hot
the
spot.
Yep.
Not around
your Mylar
here.
And
the Mylar is the one you have to file.
You
keep yeah. a couple copies, and then I forget how many. We could have three copies, John, or what? How many do we have to keep?
I think we keep
three.
Two.
Keep
three?
Three.
Let's do it
so
this way.
Keep three of the paper ones and give them the rest of them.
Yeah. I got a better idea. That'd be really helpful. Put this one on the outside. Put the Mylar on the outside? The Mylar on the inside.
Okay.
Yeah, you want to see if there's anything?
Yeah. Okay, whoops, wait a minute.
Anything in here? And I want to just talk about this contract.
Okay.
I'm handing this back to you. All messed up. Yeah, you can have
it. There you go.
There.
Okay.
Official.
Thanks for coming down.
Thank you.
So I just wanted to, one announcement is that the Select Board signed the amendment to the agreement of services with the FERCOG. If you remember the last time Pat told us that we had a contract with them for $10,000 and it ran out. But part of that $10,000 then was reimbursed by the Lake Street Solar Development and went back into our revolving fund.
Hmm.
So it was a little kind of weird. So
yeah,
we used the budget, but then the town got the money back again, but it went into a different fund. So then we had to do a new contract. So we said, wow, let's increase it by 5,000. And then part of that is so she can do this work on the Eagle Brook, mm-hmm, which is also being paid for by Eagle Brook.
So, yeah.
So none of the additional $5,000 comes from the taxpayers.
Right.
The general fund.
And what bothered me is I was on vacation this past week, and I got an email, but right before that, it was clear that the fur clog always likes the select board to sign these things. And then apparently 2 weeks ago at a select board meeting, they didn't sign it. And Doug kind of said they had some question. It wasn't a big deal, but then I said, who cares if the select board signs or not? This is the planning board's
contract. No,
the budget is our contract. It's our revolving fund.
Yes.
And I said, Pat, come to the meeting. We're going to pay you. You know, the planning board's going to pay you. We don't wait for the select board. So part of this is I think the FERCOG likes to be very formal with the select boards, and that's fine. Sure. But I just want to raise the issue that I think that might be something that we as the planning board say, what do we need the select board's approval on and what don't we?
Yeah.
Because I was on the assumption every town meeting, annual town meeting, the town votes to have that $25,000 revolving fund for the planning board.
Yeah.
There's
only two elected boards in the town, the select board and the planning board. Yeah. So I believe we have the authority to take care of our own.
So
assessors.
I think we should just maybe have a meeting with the select board and just clarify that.
One of the questions is that the planning board has the authority to disperse the money, but not really to release it. That has to go through the select
board.
Still
has to go through the select board.
In other words, you can say, look, to pay this bill for $5,000, yeah, but the planning board doesn't have the authority to take that money out of the town. The board of selectmen would have to say that, and that's kind of what brought it. I believe so.
So, but I just figured that's something that we should, because recently we've had these discussions about us getting fees paid and they go in the revolving fund, and we kind of think it's our...
But we can't take it out of the revolving fund.
So I think, and we've talked about this over the years, is that maybe more often we should have a co-meeting with the select board or something.
Mm-hmm.
Yep.
So I just put that out there again.
We get Carolyn here and we're all set.
No. It's too. I think we could have the selectmen vote right tonight what to do. Don't you? I mean, is it?
Almost. You're not
a
quorum.
I know better.
So anyway, so they did sign it. So we have this new agreement, and that goes through June 30th, and then we'll do another one with them. And again, we sign the contracts, but then it's really every case we say, okay, do this work. Like you said, ask her how much it's going to cost to do this work, and then we decide if we want her to do it or not.
One of the things that makes this unique, I think, because Pat has been doing work for the planning board for many years, but only recently have we started billing, as she started billing for this peer review type thing. You know, and it's primarily because of the size of the project. This wouldn't come about if she was just consulting on us changing a zoning bylaw or, you know, procedure about this and stuff like that. It's only because of these large scale projects. But I could ask a question. How did you deal with like some of the big, like when Deerfield Academy put up a big building, how did you deal with that site plan review? Or did you just not?
We didn't do it. They were exempt.
Yeah. We met with them.
With Deerfield Academy?
Yeah.
There was some funds that came to us, and we had to give them back to them at the end of the process. I forgot what that was for. Was it for but they did the wash area down by their...
That's the one I was on.
Yeah, so we did refund money to them when they didn't use all the money for their project. Yeah.
And we met with them with Concom.
Yeah.
I had a conversation with the building inspector, and he did say that, you know, a lot of the schools were exempt from, you know, the zoning and a lot of things. And I showed him that in state law that the exemption to the schools isn't a total exemption. They're just exempt from reasonable regulations. So if somebody would have to challenge our zoning to be unreasonable for them to, you know, say,
right.
Well.
And I think they were here for stormwater anyways. It wasn't.
Yeah. It was a stormwater issue.
Yeah,
Concom
and stormwater.
It was about stormwater. It wasn't about the building.
It was about their wash area, about their maintenance building.
Right. Mm-hmm. Calculations on sizing for
wetland protection.
Rainstorms.
Sandy came, not Sandy, but
Chucky
came in to talk to us about it that time.
Williams.
So the other thing I report is that our inspector, New England Environmental, has been checking on the solar project up at Warner property there. Do you guys get the emails from them?
Some of them.
I get a weekly. This is number 17, weekly inspection report.
I haven't got one.
So, you know, they stay on top of it. I should forward these to you. If you want to be on it, you can get on it. And they show photos of what's going on. And when there's a rain, they kind of say, they asked them to put a few more bags out there. So, you know, they seem to be doing a good job up there. I assume it's all cleared. I assume pretty soon they're going to start really getting into it, putting stuff up there. So that's nice, because that's one of the things we always wonder sometimes is, does things get monitored after we make our decisions? Like, what happens to it? So I wanted to make sure we all know that. Anything that we need to talk about?
Okay, well, this here is a pile of stuff from other towns. I don't think it's worth bringing up.
You can read it if you want.
You can read it if you want. That definitely should be addressed.
So this is a request for a comment asking the planning board, Bella Breslow, for a special permit to own and operate a bed and breakfast at her new home at 60 Grave Street. There is a notice of hearing. The Zoning Board of Appeals of the town of Deerfield will hold a public hearing on Thursday, May 5th, 2016 at 7 o'clock.
That's gone by.
That's last week. Application of Bella Breslow for a special permit to own and operate a bed and breakfast at her new home at 60 Grove Street. So I don't know if they voted or not, or whether they're still wanting our comments. Anybody have any comments?
Bed and breakfast? I think it's moot at this point.
Well, if it's already...
Not exactly on that one, but as soon as we're done with that, I do have something I need to ask you.
So no comment?
That's right, Cross Street. Oh, yeah.
I know she operated bed and breakfast up on the River Road for years.
Well, Grace D is right up here on off of Circle.
Yep.
Right. But it's Bridget, really close to
Okay,
Cross.
So other mail, we've got the certified mail for the Eagle Brook Solar, WT Land, Delta Sand and Gravel. This was one, I guess, sent to Charles William May in Pittsfield, Mass, for the same project. Edward Maltby.
The
Keats Road. Yep. Arnold and Wendy. Oh, Arnold, Wendy, and Kenneth
Wendy did get one.
Yeah, so there's that. Looks like the town of Greenfield may be doing some rezoning. That's a letter from the Planning and Development.
So this means they got the letter about the public hearing?
Yes.
Oh. All right, good. So they didn't come. They have no comments. That's what I was wondering.
So there's that. And like I said, it looks like Greenfield's doing some rezoning, or, you know, not necessarily rezoning, but doing some updates. There's large-scale photovoltaic, small-scale photovoltaic, so that might be interesting to see what they came up with.
Good.
John, my question was, I was supposed to look and I forgot. In our regulations, do we have actual description of what a bed and breakfast is?
Rachel?
The reason I ask is that...
you have it there, is it?
No, I don't see anything.
Find anything. Okay.
No. We recently approved an application for a bed and breakfast on River Road at the far end over East Deerfield that involved a barn type structure that was going to be used for Zen moments and meditation stuff. Well, it's turned into halfway between a drug addiction and a prisoner rehabilitation center.
Well, that's a lot different than bed and breakfast.
Yeah. So
In our definition, we don't have any definition.
I didn't look yet. So
back something, maybe it's in the way back to some. But certainly, this seems to be beyond any kind of definition.
Yeah, but I think that if you know, it was on my to-do list. I just ran out of time this week. So if it isn't, then I maybe at our next meeting, I might, you know, bring up a little bit of, you know, language or something we could slip in there. Because when it's real vague, the so-called people at this place, they are paying a fee to be there. So what they do there is, you know, I don't know.
And also, maybe there is a definite, like, how many units is a B&B? Like, what's the difference between that and a hotel, you know, when you get up to many
units? Is it three units or two units?
I don't know. We should have some kind of... We should have some kind of...
It seems like more and more of those come across the table, so perhaps it is something that we should look at.
Define a little bit closer.
Define them better.
Yeah, I didn't see anything.
Because Grave Street seems like an odd spot to have a bed and breakfast.
I don't know.
No, that makes sense.
I don't think that's
a nice place. Because we've had them here, you know, along.
Yeah.
Oh, I'm not saying.
Isn't there that house right there by the high school?
That's, right. And there was the one across the street from the high school that was. Yeah. They were there for a while.
I guess, you know, I presume there's got to be some kind of parking involved in it. I mean,
well, I think that's why I said Grave Street. It's
I agree. I think there should be. I mean, you think about that in terms of neighbors, you know, who's coming and going, even for, even, you know, beside the kind of stretch of the imagination.
Yeah.
But if we don't have definitions,
then we should do it.
Yeah.
I don't know where it would be.
And I have one other item that I forgot to mention earlier on.
One more mail item for anybody. This came from Barway Farm. For those who don't know, they're building a methane digester using their agricultural waste to run it. And I'm not quite sure what this letter is about. It was sent to us. I think it's something pertaining to the fact that they don't need to come in for any sort of town approvals because it's considered agriculture. If anybody wants to read it and make more of it, they absolutely can. I don't see.
They're finished.
I don't know who Mr. Jorgensen is.
I know. So this isn't addressed to us.
They've had it there for some time, haven't they?
Yeah.
Excuse me?
Haven't they had their storage tank there for some time?
Yeah.
Well, no, that's for their animal solid waste.
But isn't
the methane
isn't
thing
that what
top
feeds
of
the digester, though?
Partially, yeah.
I don't know.
Other, but I believe they're in the construction phase right now for the digester.
Mm-hmm. I don't know who's sending it to.
It says planning board.
So it's just for our information, I guess.
I think it's informational for us.
Three-year-old letter.
So what?
So I think they started their process 3 years ago. And
they
that's what
they
I'm
did.
Saying. I think they've already built the tanks that are there.
So,
one thing I had was after each year after the elections of planning board members, it's good
have
to
elections.
To have elections to see who should be chair and then vice chair of this esteemed body. And I'd be happy not to be chair, but I'd be willing to continue it as well. But I'd like. See if there's any kind of anybody wants to make a recommendation for change.
Well, if no one else wants to do it, I'll nominate you. I mean, I would like to do it, but I think with my other job, I think it's best that I don't do that. So
plus, you got a raise with your other job.
That's right.
And I didn't want it.
And he's the one that wants it.
You can turn it back.
Donate
in.
It.
That's right.
Give it to the planning board.
I'll second that motion. That John chair.
We can keep the current slate. Can we move? Can you move that we keep the current slate?
So right now, I think you're
the vice.
Vice chair.
You're the vice chair.
And we got the clerk here. Yeah.
And clerk. So I was going to nominate him, but he didn't want.
Or what?
All right. So if we want to do that, then can I make a
vote?
A recommendation. Well, let's vote, I guess. We should vote.
Oh, all in favor?
Favor aye. To keep aye. Everything the same?
Abstain.
Like I wasn't here last week to vote for myself either.
Right.
But.
So it's 5-0-1.
Can I make a...
The motion is to keep you as chair? Or
keep him as chair.
Well, keep me as chair.
As vice chair.
Kip as vice chair.
And current slate of officers.
But I would like to add, years ago, I remember saying, well, I'm happy to facilitate the meetings, and I think I do have a good track record of being here, and so that's important. But some of the in-between stuff, I don't. So this is great. You're going to contact Greg Newman.
Yeah.
And then also just, like, setting the agenda and stuff, there was a time when you were kind of more in touch
yep.
with the administrator. So if you could Okay. Maybe right. I like it. I'm trying to make sure I CC the three of us are CC'd on a lot of that organizing stuff,
sure.
And it's not decision making, so it's not out of bounds. But it's that way, if I'm not around, you guys couldn't respond and say right. Yes, we're going to have a meeting and we have to have a public hearing or something, and then reminding people, you know, just keeping some of the emails going, so I don't have to feel so responsible.
Okay. Well, I just also want to say that I'm new to the world of all of these little electronic gadgets. So if somebody receives something from me that they shouldn't, I apologize. It won't be of a bad nature, but...
But it might be wonder why we get it from you.
Yeah. Like, yeah.
We'll just have a thing. Oh, that's good.
And if it's okay, I'd like to bring something up. You know, the planning board is the only truly volunteer elected board left in this town, and I think that we should be allowed to use whatever tools are available to help the chair, the vice chair, and the clerk, whether it be administrative in town hall or whatever, because again, we are truly the only volunteer board, and I don't have a problem with that. I am very proud to serve voluntarily, but it is volunteer, and mm-hmm. it should not take up huge amounts of time other than the actual meeting. So what do we have in town hall that can help? Mr. Selectman, maybe you can...
I think Doug has been doing a good job, you know, for us anyways.
Absolutely.
You know,
and I
don't see anything there changing in the near future. He got a great assistant as well, and I know she's been very helpful to him. She's stepping in this week. But also, I clicked something else. At my first select board meeting, I did make a mention that the planning board would like to be kept apprised of any new building projects coming in to the town.
Yeah,
and
good.
You know, as soon as they're available, I will know.
All right. So why don't we have try to put on the next agenda, or at least one of the next 2 months, a discussion with the town staff. So if Doug's going to be here, which he often is, we can just clarify what each other's roles a little bit. Make right. sure we got that everybody kind of understands it. That'd be great.
And will Doug contact Pat Smith about getting some...
I'm on it because he's away. Since he's away, I'm happy to do that, and that's an easy enough thing. Easy enough thing to do. Okay.
So what are we going to be looking for? Information on current solar zoning?
Yeah, well, I'm going to follow up with her a little on this Eaglebrook thing, and then also that, and see what kind of plan, see if she can recommend how we should go about it. That's all I'm going to ask. Anything else?
Good. Next meeting?
Next Six meeting, June 6th? Oh, we did that when we were talking about the Eaglebrook thing.
So you're trying to excuse me.
So the first item on that June 6th is, we didn't close the hearing?
Continue the hearing.
The public hearing. So we'll open the public hearing and probably close it quickly.
Well,
and the stormwater. And the special permit. Yeah.
Oh, before you close, if anybody wants to hear what happened at the Franklin planning meeting.
Yes, because you're our representative.
The pipeline, right now, it's in limbo. It's by, I don't believe by any means that it's dead, but it's in sort of a hibernation phase, I guess, for lack of better.
Wasn't it funny, though, that our state government came out right after that announcement saying that, you know, we direly need natural gas?
Well, and I believe that
Berkshire,
we do.
Yeah, I mean, that's
no, not Berkshire, do. The state, the director of, is it public utilities?
You should get Wes on that subject.
In Salem, Mass., there's a cogeneration plant that's in construction. There will be a pipeline, whether anybody likes it or not.
Is that coming down from...
Oh, you've got the...
It'll be somewhere.
Yeah.
It is going to happen. And I'm not going to say unfortunately. It's just...
gas feeds west to east in this state.
You know, this Berkshire Gas bump up plant.
Well, it's not Berkshire Gas
it.
Anymore. It's a big company now.
Well, no, but I'm saying over in Waitley, that plant wouldn't be there if the supply was...
Well, as I understand it,
anyway, we're getting a report out from the Franklin... Yeah.
Right. So, okay, so that's about the pipeline. There was some discussion, Town of Irving taking over that paper plant. I forget which one they call it, but it's the one in Montague. If you go through the center of Miller's Falls, you go down the hill over that little bridge.
No, no, not the Strathmore. It's the Miller's Falls paper plant.
Miller's Falls paper.
The old IP plant up there.
Yeah, I think it was IP. Well, they took it for lack of taxes, and now they're trying to figure out what to do with it.
Right.
And my question to the selectman was, why'd you take it? And he's like, I don't know.
And did he ask you, why didn't Deerfield take the Oxford plant? Or...
We did take it.
But that was already
I know, but it's
apples and oranges, John.
I don't know.
But yes, that's a good question also. and that was really it. There's always some discussion about the Mount Hermon
campus. Northfield campus.
Northfield Mount Hermon.
Northfield campus of
Mount Northfield.
Yeah, Northfield.
Well, the electrical generating Northfield Mountain, and there's always some discussion.
Okay. There's always some discussion
about the level of the water and with the erosion and things like that.
Right. And they're seeking to be re.
You know, there's one person on the board that diligently works on that. And that's really about it.
Okay.
So.
Then the next one, maybe one of the next meetings, you can ask about solar. How many towns are?
Yeah, that's.
Because that's the kind of place that planning boards are supposed to share information. Kind of.
Right.
So maybe they'll
right.
take it up as one of their issues.
Good point. Good point. Maybe I'll email the chair.
Yeah.
I make a motion to adjourn.
Second.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Have a good evening. Thank you.